Now, chances are, if you've gone online to buy a DVD box set, a bumper pack of vitamins or a bunch of roses, you'll have paid less if your order was delivered from the Channel Islands. But thanks to a measure in last week's budget, the VAT loophole that's made such competitive pricing possible is set to begin closing. Well, our business reporter Pauline McCool has been looking into this. Pauline?
Yes, now, although many people are aware that it's cheaper because of the VAT anomaly to get stuff sent to you from the Channel Islands, most of us have no idea why it exists. And in fact, the Treasury Minister, Lord Sassoon, was asked about the origins of this loophole in the House of Lords last month, and he had to admit that before he could answer, he had to go away and find out what it was all about. So here we are. Lord Sassoon, if you're listening. Many years ago, it was agreed that the Channel Islands should be considered to be outside the European Union for tax purposes, and that led to something known as the Low Value Consignment Relief, LVCR, under the terms of which retailers can ship goods worth £18 or less, VAT-free from, well, Jersey and Guernsey mostly. Now, the relief was specifically intended, back then in the 1970s, to protect the Channel Islands' fresh flower industry, very important to the islands. Those are the days before it discovered financial services, of course, and tax evasion. But the advent of internet shopping has led to a massive range of internet and mail order retailers basically flocking to the Channel Islands to gain a competitive advantage by undercutting mainland retailers with VAT-free goods. And it is anything from, as you say, CDs, DVDs, perfume, vitamins, supplements, and of course, traditionally still, flowers and seeds.
So what does the Chancellor intend to do about it?
Well, he says that this loophole is now being exploited and used in a way that it was not intended to originally. He actually accused both consumers and retailers of taking advantage of it, although I'm not quite sure how as consumers you can take advantage of it. You can only take advantage of the offers that are out there. There's been intense lobbying about this LVCR and the way it's being a growing issue for high street retailers here in the UK who are struggling to compete with the kind of VAT discounts that you can have offered to you. The Treasury itself estimates that it's losing some £180 million a year in VAT lost because of the practice. Lobby groups have been arguing strongly that the figure is higher and something must be done. So, in apparent response to all these complaints, the Chancellor made this promise in the budget.
And we're going to tackle the exploitation of low-value consignment relief that has left our high street music stores fighting a losing battle with warehouses in the Channel Islands.
So that was a bit vague, so further investigation proved that what he was actually talking about was a reduction in that threshold from £18 to £15, which the average price of a CD or a DVD, a single one, is still below that, so it's not quite as restrictive as you might imagine. We did ask the Treasury for an update on the chances of this exemption disappearing altogether, and a spokesperson confirmed to Unioners that the government is going to also explore options with the European Commission to limit the scope of the relief further. But in addition, they also told us that if discussions with the European Commission don't produce a workable solution to the exploitation of LVCR, the government will revisit the level of the relief in the budget of 2012.
Okay, I will watch out for next year. Pauline McCool, thank you. Richard Allen is from the campaigning group Retailers Against VAT Avoidance Schemes. Phil Balderson is the chief executive of Health Spark, which is a Jersey internet business selling health supplements. Richard, first of all, I mean, the threshold, as Pauline explained, for the LVCR has only been lowered by £3, and yet you're, I understand it, optimistic. Why?
Well, I know what's going on in the background. The UK government has been engaged in talks with the Commission for at least 2 years on this issue now. And I think this is just it's a political gesture at this point to show that the government's serious about dealing with this.
So will it have any impact in the short term?
£15 won't have much of an impact at all. I think what's more significant is that the Chancellor used the words that the relief was being used for a purpose for which it was not intended, which has been our point from the very beginning.
OK, let me bring in Phil Balderson. I mean, you also, I think this budget announcement signals a warning shot from the government. So what would the impact be on your business and indeed on Jersey in general?
Well, I think for many businesses in the Channel Islands, we're already supplying many goods and products above £18. And what perhaps a lot of listeners don't appreciate is that we're actually collecting VAT on those items and paying that VAT directly to Her Majesty's Treasury.
But okay, which might be all right for Her Majesty's Treasury, but how do you respond to those who say that businesses who benefit from the LVCR are actually damaging the UK high street?
Well, I don't see it as it could be damaging the UK high street. I think this is really about choice for the consumer. There's no doubt that internet shopping is growing exponentially and the high street's got to adapt to this change. At HealthSpark, we've seen massive growth online in the last 2 years, which shows that consumers clearly want to buy online and they want good value.
Let me put that to you, Richard. I mean, don't you agree that low prices are good for consumers? And as Pauline said, consumers are obviously, they can only take the offers that are actually there.
Yeah, I think that's been slightly confused there with what was said. VAT is paid in the Channel Islands, but on a very small percentage of the products. I mean, one of the major retailers based in Jersey has offices and staff in the UK, and they only send goods from the Channel Islands that are below the threshold. So I think it's slightly misleading to make that point. But with regards to the consumer issue...
So you mean, let me just make this clear. So you mean that goods actually sent out by groups that are or companies that are based in the UK, they actually go to Jersey and then back again?
Yeah, the goods are sent there. I mean, there are goods that are coming into the UK from outside of the EU that are actually originating from outside the EU, but there are a small, very small percentage of the products we're talking about here. We're talking about things that are deliberately sent out of the UK. I have sympathy with retailers that are operating outside of the EU, but you know, that's not what's causing the problem. It's the deliberate exporting of UK product and EU product to gain the tax advantage that is the issue.
Phil Balderson, I mean, we know that companies, I think, went to Jersey to actually, because of this. Will you consider moving your business in the other direction if the LVCR is abolished altogether?
No, we won't. I mean, HealthSpark's committed to being in Jersey because we're from Jersey. We live in Jersey, we work in Jersey. But we are outside of the EU and we don't pay VAT here. And that means that UK consumers can benefit from lower prices. I think we should also address, though, that this isn't a tax loophole. Low-value consignment relief was never about cream and flowers and perishables. That's a myth. It's an international convention. And in most places in the world, it exists at a much higher rate. For example, it's $2,000 in the US and it's $1,000 in Australia, because quite simply, it's too expensive to collect.
But it's a way of getting round a British tax, isn't it?
No, I think it's just a fact of life. We're supplying from the UK. There are millions of items arriving via internet sales into the UK from all over the world. I think it's wrong that the Channel Islands have been singled out in this way, because actually we're one of the few jurisdictions that's cooperating fully with the UK. We're unilaterally collecting tax on behalf of the UK government on all items above the threshold. And to the best of my knowledge, no other jurisdiction's doing that.
So, Richard Allen, what do you say about that? Because, of course, your business, I think you were actually in the CD business yourself. Yeah. That was presumably directly affected, you felt, by what was coming from Jersey.
Well, I mean, I don't agree with that information. I mean, firstly, most of the products coming in under LVCR, something like 80%, come from the UK. So it's not true that there are huge amounts of products coming in from outside of the UK. So we're talking, I mean, because most consumers want UK brands, and in the case of music and DVDs, you can only sell products that come from within the UK, because if you try and sell anything from another territory, then the BPI, which is the music industry body that polices this, will prosecute you, and that has happened in the past with regards to CDs and DVDs. So I don't agree with that issue.
Can I just, with you first of all, Richard, what do you want to see? Do you want to see the exemption taken away altogether?
Well, I'd just like to make a very simple point. If there was no such thing as VAT and you were operating a mail order company and you were based in Jersey, it would make absolutely no sense at all to run a warehouse and a fulfillment operation on an island on the other side of the channel. Because if all your customers are in the UK, you would be sending the stuff to Jersey and then sending it back again for no reason. It would be much better to have a warehouse and a fulfillment operation on the UK mainland, and you could quite easily run that from Jersey as a business operation. So,
Phil Balderson, final word on that?
I think Jersey and Guernsey would welcome the opportunity to consult with the EU on the issue. We've got a vibrant and a valid industry, and whilst the reduction from £18 to £15 is significant, we're not going to give up without a fight, because we believe that consumers should have the right to choose.
Richard Allen and Phil Balderson, thank you both very much indeed.